Hello everyone, in this video I'll be discussing with you on PTSD, that is post-traumatic stress disorder. Well, I'm Reema Stanley, tutor at Triple M College of Nursing. So at the end of this video, you'll be able to define PTSD, list the incidents of PTSD, explain the symptoms of PTSD, describe the risk factors for PTSD, explain the diagnostic criteria which is used for PTSD, and discuss the management for PTSD. So now let us see what is post-traumatic stress disorder. So it is otherwise in short PTSD. So this particular disorder, it was once called as a shell shock or a battle fatigue syndrome. So it is a serious condition that can develop after a person has experienced or witnessed a traumatic or terrifying event in which there was serious physical harm or threat. Now let us see by definition what is PTSD. So PTSD is characterized by hyperarousal, re-experiencing of images of stressful events, and avoidance of reminders. So people, PTSD is a reaction to extreme stresses such as flood, earthquakes, war, sexual or physical assault, the unexpected death of a loved one, an accident, war, or a natural disaster. And families of victims can also develop PTSD, or a person who is working in an emergency or a rescue workers, although they have not actually experienced a traumatic event, but they could also be the person who could cause develop PTSD. So most people who have a traumatic event will have a reaction that may include shock, anger, nervousness, fear, or even guilt. And these reactions are common, and for most people, they can go away over a period of time. And for a person with PTSD, however, these feelings continue and even increases, becoming so strong that they keep the person from going about with their lives as expected. Okay, they will have a poor functioning, etc. So people with PTSD have symptoms for longer than 1 month and cannot function as well as like before the event have occurred. So now let us see how common is PTSD. So in America, the study shows that about 3 to 6% of adults would suffer from PTSD, and about 5.2 million of people have PTSD during the course of a year, and an estimate of 7.8 million Americans would develop PTSD at some point in their lives. So PTSD can develop actually at any age, including childhood. Women, however, women are most likely to develop PTSD than men. And this may be due to the fact that women are more likely to be victims of domestic violence, abuse, and rape. And there's another study which was done post disaster research, which is published in Indian Journal of Psychiatry, which shows that the study was done among the people in Orissa, and it shows that there was PTSD about 44.3% among the people who were affected from tsunami. Now let us see what are symptoms of PTSD. Well, the symptoms of PTSD most often begin within 3 months of the event. In some cases, however, they don't begin until years later. And the severity and duration of the illness can also vary from person to person. Some people recover within 6 months, while others might be much longer. So the symptoms of PTSD are often grouped in these four main categories, and these include relieving symptoms, avoiding symptoms, arousal, negative cognitions, and mood. So let us see each one. Relieving means People with PTSD repeatedly relive the thoughts and memories of the trauma. So this may include such as flashbacks, hallucinations, and nightmares. They may also feel great distress especially when certain things that reminds them of the trauma, such as the anniversary date of the event, etc. While avoiding symptoms, the person may avoid people, places, certain thoughts that is disturbing them, or situations that may remind them of the trauma. So this can lead to feelings of detachment and isolation from family and friends, as well as a loss of interest in activities that a person would once enjoy. Next is the arousal symptoms. So this include excessive emotion, mainly problems relating to others, including feelings or showing affection, etc. They may also have difficulty falling or staying asleep, irritability, outbursts of anger, difficulty in concentrating, or being easily startled. And the person may also suffer physical symptoms such as increase in blood pressure, heart rate, rapid breathing, muscle tension, nausea, and diarrhea, etc. These are all part of arousal symptoms. Now, the negative cognitions and mood, this refers to thoughts and feelings related to such as blame, memories of the traumatic events, etc. Now, young children with PTSD may have delayed development in areas such as toilet training, motor skills, and language. And the intensity of PTSD symptoms may vary, and they may often feel more stressed in general. Okay, and they also encounter a specific reminder, especially they feel stressed when they encounter a specific reminder about what happened. So to summarize the symptoms of PTSD, this include re-experiencing symptoms such as flashbacks, palpitations, sweatings, bad dreams, frightening thoughts. Okay, so these are the common symptoms under re-experiencing symptoms. Now, avoidance symptoms. This include like staying away from places, events, or objects that reminds of traumatic experiences, then avoiding certain thoughts or feelings related to a traumatic events, etc. While arousal and reactivity symptoms, this include being easily startled, feeling tense or always on the edge, having difficulty sleeping, and having anger outburst. While cognitive and mood symptoms include such as trouble remembering, that is poor memory. Okay, the key features is trouble remembering of the traumatic events. Then negative thoughts of about oneself or the world itself, distorted feelings like guilt, blame, and also loss of interest in enjoyable activities. Now let us see the risk factors of PTSD. So before we go into that, I give you a brief introduction. So anyone can develop PTSD at any age, and this includes children and people who have been through physical or sexual assault, abuse, accident, disaster, or other serious event. But not everyone with PTSD has been through a dangerous event. Some people can even develop PTSD after a friend or a family member experiences danger or a harm. So it is also important for you to remember that not everyone who lives through a dangerous event develops PTSD. In fact, most people will not develop the disorder. So there are many factors that play a role in whether a person will develop a PTSD. So there are also some which I'll be discussing with you. Also, there are some risk factors that makes a person more likelihood to develop PTSD for some factors, while other factors such as called as resilient factors, can also help reduce the risk of the disorder. So here are some of the risk factors that might lead the person to develop PTSD. So such as living through a dangerous event and trauma, getting hurt all the time, seeing other person hurt or seeing a dead body, childhood trauma, feeling horror, helplessness, or extreme fear, having little or no social support after the event, okay, or dealing with extreme stress after the event, such as loss of a loved one, pain, an injury, a loss of a job or a home. All this can lead to PTSD, and also a history of any mental illness or a substance abuse can also lead to PTSD. So here are some of the factors that promotes recovery after trauma, and this include seeking out support from other people such as friends and family, finding a support group after a traumatic event, learning to feel good about oneself, about one's own action in the face of a danger, having a positive coping strategy or a way of getting through the bad events and learning from it, being able to act and respond effectively despite feeling fear. Okay, so these are some of the factors that also helps in promote recovery after a trauma. Now, the diagnosis is done. For an adult, they should have all the following symptoms for at least 1 month, and this includes at least one re-experiencing symptoms, which we have discussed earlier. Okay, so at least one avoidance symptoms, and at least two arousal and reactivity symptoms, and at least two cognitive and mood symptoms. Okay, so this is the exact pattern which needed to be investigated on the person, and if the person falls in this category, it can be diagnosed as PTSD. Now let us see the treatment and therapies. So the main treatment for people with PTSD are medication, psychotherapy, which is otherwise called as talk therapy, or both. Everyone is different, and PTSD affects people differently. So a treatment that works for one person might not work for another. So it is also important for everyone with PTSD to be treated by a mental health provider and who is experienced in handling person with PTSD. So some of the medications which are used include like antidepressant medication, mainly which is used to treat PTSD and to control anxiety and its associated symptoms. Okay, so the categories of those medications include selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors, example like sertraline, fluoxetine, etc. Tricyclic antidepressant like amitriptyline, mood stabilizers such as divalprax, etc. And also atypical antipsychotics, mainly like quetiapine can be used. There are also some studies which shows that they actually discourage the use of tranquilizers such as lorazepam and clonazepam for people with PTSD, because it has shown that it's not that helpful, and they actually carry the risk for physical dependence or addiction. Now, the psychotherapy, sometimes which is always called as talk therapy, involves talking with a mental health professional, and this can occur either on a one-to-one or in a group system, okay, and usually lasts for 6 to 12 weeks, but it can also last longer, and research also shows that support from family and friends can also be an important part of recovery. So one of the effective form of the therapy is cognitive behavioral therapy, which includes exposure therapy. So this helps people to actually control their fear. It also gradually helps them to expose themselves to the trauma they experience in a safe way. It also it can be used either by imagining or writing or visiting the place where the event happened, and the therapist used this tool to help people with PTSD to cope with their feelings. Now, the cognitive restructuring, this helps people actually make sense about the bad memories. Sometimes people remember the event differently than how it happened. They may feel guilt or shame about something that is not their fault. So the therapies would help people with PTSD look at what happened in a more realistic way. Now, the other psychodynamic therapy, such as family therapy, is also very helpful because the behavior of the person, especially with PTSD, can also affect the other family members. So family therapy is also effective. Now, group therapy, this is effective because it allows the person to share the thoughts, fears, and feelings about the other people who have experienced a traumatic events. So the key notes, PTSD is a disorder that develops in some people who have experienced a shocking, scary, or dangerous event. And the symptoms of PTSD includes such as re-experiencing symptoms, avoidance symptoms, arousal and reactivity symptoms, also cognitive and mood symptoms. Now, diagnostic framework is done when a person experiences all the above symptoms for at least 1 month. So National Post-Traumatic Stress Disorder Awareness Day is celebrated on the 27th of June every year. So reference, Srivani, A Guide to Mental Health and Psychiatric Nursing. You can also log in to NIMHANS website and also webmed.com. Thank you.